Welcome back to PSC Tech Bytes. This week, we are going to talk about how to provision Teams tabs built with the SharePoint Framework. In fact, since SharePoint Framework 1.8.x, we can create a client-side web path, which can be used also as the content of a Teams tab in Microsoft Teams. And in order to do that, you can leverage all of the capabilities of SharePoint Framework, plus a Teams context object, which we will cover in one of the upcoming videos. By doing that, you can easily extend the UI of Microsoft Teams with custom code built using SharePoint Framework. And in order to provision such kind of extensions, you can either use a Sync to Teams button that is available in the app catalog of your SharePoint Online tenant, or by creating a JSON manifest file that you will have to manually create and include in a zip file that you can upload in the Teams apps catalog. So let me move to the demo environment and let me show you how you can do that in practice. So here I am in Visual Studio Code and I have a fresh new SharePoint Framework solution that I just created using the Yeoman generator. And here we have a client-side web part, a very simple out-of-the-box client-side web part built using React, as well as a Teams folder in which I have a couple of PNG images which will be used to represent in the UI of Microsoft Teams a custom tab which will render and include my custom client-side web part. If I want to provision this solution on Microsoft Teams, whatever it will be the content, and right now I will just use the out-of-the-box content, I will simply need to do the well-known gulp build or gulp bundle if I want to prepare the bundle for shipping. So gulp bundle dash dash ship, and then gulp package solution dash dash ship. And after that, I will have a new SPPKG package that I can upload in the app catalog of my SharePoint Online tenant. By doing that, I will also be able to provision my client-side web part in Microsoft Teams as long as in the manifest of my client-side web part, I specify that the supported host is not only the SharePoint web part, but also, for example, the Teams tab. So I'm declaring that I want to be able to provision this client-side web part as a Teams tab. So let me save the manifest, and by packaging, bundling, and packaging the solution, I will be able to do the provisioning of my custom Teams tab in Microsoft Teams. So the bundling is almost done, and I will be then ready to do the packaging of my solutions. So here we are almost, and that's it. So gulp now package solution dash dash ship. By doing that, I will have the SPPKG file in the SharePoint folder of my solution. And in fact, the SharePoint folder is now popping up here. I have a solution folder, and if I reveal it in Explorer, I can get access to the SPPKG file, which represents my solution. I go to the app catalog of my tenant, and I simply upload the SPPKG file in the app catalog. Then I can deploy and enable the solution to be tenant-wide available. I can deploy it, and by refreshing my page, I will be able to select my custom solution, which was called SPFX Sample Teams Provisioning. So let me search for that in my app catalog, and here it is. I select the package, and in the Files tab, I can click on the Syncs to Teams button. And as you will see, by clicking on this button, I will shortly see a message here that my solution has been successfully synced with Microsoft Teams. And by doing that, I can go back to a team, to a channel, and I can add a new tab, which will be represented by my custom client-side web part. The custom client-side web part will be called Sample Teams Web Part, and is this one, as you can see, and I can add it to my channel and be ready to play with it in my Microsoft Teams user interface. It's a matter of a few seconds from now. I can save the settings, and I can get access to my client-side web part inside the UI of Microsoft Teams. Bear in mind that when you do that, every now and then there could be some small issues in the provisioning through the Sync to Teams tab button, as you can see in this article on docsmics.com. And if that will be the case, you can always fall back on creating a manual manifest file, which you can copy from here. If you do that, you will simply need to create a manifest.json file in your SharePoint Framework solution. So for example, here in the Teams folder, you create a manifest.json file. The content will be the one that you can copy from the document in docsmics.com. And you will have to replace this attribute, this property, with the alias that you have in the manifest of your client-side web part. You will have to provide the title of your solution right here, which you can get from the pre-configured entries of your solution. So let me replace it with this one with the real value, as well as you can get the description from here, and you can replace the short and long description with that value. Moreover, you will also have to replace the component ID with the real unique identifier of your client-side web part. Precisely here in the name of the images that will be used to represent your manifest, as well as in the URL for editing and provisioning your component in the Microsoft Teams UI. By doing that, again, you already provisioned the sppkg file in your target SharePoint Online app catalog. You will simply need to go to the Windows Explorer and to create a zip file with these three files, the manifest file and the two PNG files. By doing that, and let me do that right now, add to archive, I will create a zip file, which will be my sample team web part.zip file. By doing that, you can go back to Microsoft Teams and you can go to manage your team, and under the apps section you can upload a custom app. You will have to provide the path of the zip file that you just created, and you will have to upload the zip file. And as you will see, in a matter of few seconds, we will have our custom app available. Actually, we already have the other one that we created using the Sync to Teams, so I'm actually doing the same things, but it was just for the sake of showing you the different options that you have. As usual, thank you for watching this video. I hope you found it useful, and I'm really looking forward to seeing you next week. Thank you.